In today's video, I'm going to review the RS Tech belt drive kit. I've had it installed on my bike for 1 month now and have clocked up 1,000 kilometers. While that's a little bit low for me, the weather conditions here in Thailand have been less than ideal. Stay tuned as I dive into the pros and cons of this belt drive kit. I didn't initially seek out a belt drive kit. My interest peaked after a friend fitted one to his Royal Enfield Continental 650. That led me to RS Tech, who were looking for a Super Meteor 650 to test their belt drive kit on. I volunteered my bike and shared the experience on my new YouTube channel. That video has gained over 40,000 views in just 2 months, showing their significant interest in this product. So, what's the big deal about a belt drive? Well, the most significant benefit is no more oily mess. This is the first bike I've owned where I don't have to use oil on the chain. It might not sound like much, but not having to clean that greasy mess is a huge relief. Another major benefit is the smooth power transfer when rolling on and off the throttle. You have to feel it to believe it. This smoothness is likely why Harley-Davidson fits the belt drive on most of its bikes these days. It's a premium priced option, but if it performs as advertised, it can save you money in the long run by reducing the need to replace chains and sprockets frequently. And talking of chains and sprockets, RS Tech advertise that the belt drive kit is 450 grams lighter than the genuine chain and sprockets. Well, it's back to old rainy season. It rains every day, and I still use my bike every day. Even though it's raining, I've got a decent set of waterproofs, and this is the first problem I've had with the belt drive so far. It started to squeak, so I thought it was just the rain that was doing it, so I left it for a week. But what's happened, it's like a month now since I've had the belt drive, and I've done 1,000 kilometers on the belt drive in a month. And I think it's stretched just a fraction, a little bit. The belt has stretched a little bit, which is bound to, right? It's a brand new belt. I haven't tensioned it or checked the tension since it was fitted. So today is tension checking day. Stupidly, I was thinking, oh, RS Tech have fitted my belt and tensioned it correctly. I'm not gonna touch it. But you're gonna have to retension your belt within the first 1,000 kilometers for sure. So this is a quick video today in the rain. I'm just going to retension my belt, and hopefully that will stop the squeaky noise and stop the little bit of wear that is starting to show on my rear sprocket. So I don't think there's anything to worry about. It's just that my fault, I didn't retension it quick enough. And this is the problem I have, is the water. The roads are just waterlogged with clay soil, and it's very abrasive. It is very abrasive. So I take it there's some of that getting between the belt and the sprocket also. Not that it's causing me any problems at the moment, as long as I keep my belt tensioned correctly, which I haven't. So it's naughty me. I will tension it right now. And this is the wear I'm starting to see. It's not much, but if you can imagine, clay soil in Thailand is everywhere. So when it rains, there's clay soil in the water, and it's very abrasive. So I have abrased my rear sprocket on the trailing edge of the sprocket, which I take it indicates also that the belt isn't tight enough. It doesn't feel very tight, and we're going to check it today and reset it. So as you can see, I'm not afraid to use the bike. I'm not afraid to get it dirty.
and I'm using it every day. So if anybody's going to put the belt drive through a decent test, it's going to be old teacher T, right? Last weekend, I tidied the garage and bought this new toolbox kit to keep my tools tidy. I have bought myself a torque wrench, and we also need my solid bar and a 24 mil socket. So I do apologize about the state of cleanliness of my bike, but as you can see, there's little point in cleaning it at the moment because every day I use it, it's going to get dirty. So we've got our 24 mil socket. I'm just going to loosen the tension. We're not going to fully release the tension. We still want a bit of tension there. So maybe half a turn, three quarters of a turn is enough, because we're going to do the rest with the tension, the tension nuts, just to pull the wheel back slightly. We're going to pull it back a fraction, just minute turns. And remember, what you do on one side, you have to do exactly the same on the other side to actually keep the alignment. So I'm just going to move it a fraction. I'd rather move it too less than too much, because making the wheel go forward again is more problematic. So an eighth of a turn is all I've done. 1/8 of a turn. I'm going to do that now the same the other side. So 1/8 of a turn again. There. And that has already made such a difference on the tension of the belt. So much tighter. Now it's more difficult to turn. Doing the 45 degree check. If we can turn it more than 45 degrees, it's too loose. If we can't turn it to 45 degrees, it's too tight. That's the quick check to do it without the adjustment tool. So that does feel about right, actually. So today I have the same problem as everyone else. I'm on my own today. How on earth do I tension the belt with my own weight on it when there's no one here to help me? So I thought of a solution. I hope it's going to work. Remember my Hagon shocks? When I tested them, I pushed the support rubbers all the way down the bottom. I'm going to do that again today, sit on the bike. And then I know how much the suspension has to drop. Yeah, they're reset right down to the very bottom. I'm now going to sit on the bike with my body weight. Remember, we're on the center stand. So there we go. Going to bounce it a little bit. Wow, that is actually quite a surprise. That has moved further than I thought. What are we supposed to have it on? Preload, 25% movement, 20 to 25%. I think I'm nearly there. So I might actually, before I tension the belt now, is put my Hagons to settings preload 2, because since they've been new, I have noticed they're not as comfortable as they were when they were first new. When they were first new, I noticed such a difference. Maybe I've just got used to it, I don't know. But I'm going to set them to setting 2 now also. So because I'm going to retension the belt, it kind of makes sense to change the preload now. Otherwise, it would mean changing the tension again if I changed the preload, I think. So we'll get it done now. There we go, I'm on preload 2. So I'm just using a piece of cord here for alignment, tied on the rear of the pulley. On the front pulley, it should be level. Away from the front pulley, touch the front pulley, touch the front face of the front pulley, and it's level. So it's working. This side I'm on 6. Would that be 6? From the top, I'm on 6. It's even different at the bottom. But from the top line, it's saying I'm on 6.
Let's check the other side. The top line is saying I'm on nearly 7.
It's a case of torquing to 70 newton meters. Clicks when it's at the right setting. So that should be us, we should be done. We'll just take the bike off the centre stand. Just carry out one more check. So I'm just going to use a normal tape measure and just stand it on the floor. I'll put that behind the belt. Got my gauge tensioning tool. You just set the O-ring to the 10-pound mark, which is there. Push it up until it reaches the O-ring, and then that's enough pressure for the belt. And we shouldn't get more than 17 to 18 millimeters. That's the plan. We are at 6.5 centimeters. We are at 4.7 centimeters. 6.5 minus 4.7.
1.8 centimeters, 18 millimeters, perfect.
Very dirty bike, very dirty bike. I'm gonna take it out for a quick spin. Come back and give it a wash, I think. Just hope and pray that tomorrow it doesn't rain and I can keep a clean bike for at least a day. It's stopped raining and I've got a clean bike again ish and what I did was took a brush and just cleaned the belt like this. And ever since I've done that and tightened it, I don't have any more squeaks, so that has solved it. And adjusting my Hagons to preload 2, it's definitely softened my ride again. So that's one problem I do foresee with the kit. It does put the back wheel right to the back of the swing arm. So if you can understand that's leverage, it does kick it up more. I wish we could be at the front and not at the back, because I think that would make the shock absorbers work less. So, and interestingly enough, I've seen a modification on a Facebook group. I'll post a link, actually. Not a link, I'll post a photo and tell me what you think about this modification. Good or bad, safe or not, what do you think?
An ingenious kit pushing the rear suspension back further and therefore lowering the bike at the same time. Relatively inexpensive, and if you would like me to review this with my original shocks, I'm quite happy to do so. So please comment and let me know in the comments below. So just to recap about the belt drive, some real major benefits. I will give it another 1,000 kilometers before I do another review. If there's anything major happens in the meantime, I will let you know. As always, thanks for watching. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to Teacher T's channel. And until next time, ride safe, and I'll see you on a video soon.